Hello friends, welcome to our channel Mechanical Motivator. In this video we will be seeing introduction to balancing of rotating masses. Nowadays high speed engine and other machineries are now becoming a common phenomenon. Therefore it is very essential that all the rotating and reciprocating parts should be completely balanced as far as possible. So for that we need to balance, right? So we will be having two different balancing. One will be static balancing and another one will be dynamic balancing. In static balancing, what happens is we will be having all the masses in the same plane. So here three different masses are there and all the masses will be acting in the same plane. Whereas in dynamic balancing, we will be having three different masses which will be in three different planes. So we are having three different masses and all the masses are rotating in different plane. So this is the basic difference between static and dynamic. And in static balancing, we'll be getting two equations. That is, the summation of force along x-axis will be zero and summation of forces on y-axis will be zero. So here we'll be dealing with only forces. We won't deal with couple. But whereas in dynamic balancing, the summation of forces will be zero, as well as the couple or moment will be zero. So here we'll be getting three different equations. So in static we'll be getting two equations and in dynamic we'll be getting three equations. So this is the basic difference between static and dynamic balancing. Here we can see a plane. So there are two different masses which will be acting on the same plane. In static balancing, as I said already, we'll be dealing with summation of forces alone. So summation of forces will be equal to zero. But whereas in dynamic, we will be dealing with couple also, that is moment. Summation of moment will also be equal to zero. So here we are having two different masses which are rotating in two different planes and we'll be having the same, the shaft will be having a same angular velocity. So just imagine if in case the summation of all the forces are not equal to zero means, then there will be some unbalance induced into the system. So in order to avoid that, we're going to add some other mass to counterattack it. So just have a look at this diagram. Here we are having a plane and three different masses are rotating in the same plane. So mass here, this denotes mass M1 and this denotes mass M2 and this is the third mass. And all the three masses will be having a radius like respective radius like R1, R2 and R3. And they are at an angle of theta 1, theta 2 and theta 3. So here the shaft will be having, will be rotating with a common, not common, it's a same angular velocity omega. So now we will be seeing in detail. That is, here take an example of this. Actually what happens, just imagine as I already said, both rotating as well as reciprocating parts should be completely balanced as far as possible. Hence, not if some case, if these parts are not properly balanced means, then what happens? Dynamic forces will set up in the shaft. First, initially when the shaft will revolving without any mass means, then there won't be any imbalance. But if there is a mass we add, if a mass is added to the shaft means, automatically this mass will tend to bend the shaft or else it also, create some vibration. So in order to avoid that, we're going to counterattack and another mass. So these forces not only increase the load on the bearing, but also produces some stresses at various members or various parts. So what happens? These forces will be producing an unbalanced or unpleasant or even dangerous vibrations. So these are the drawbacks if you are not balancing. If there is an unbalance means, these are the drawbacks. So what we're going to do, whenever a certain mass is attached to a rotating shaft, it exerts some centrifugal force. So when a mass is attached to a shaft means, then there will be a centrifugal force which will be acting outwards. So whose effect will tend to bend the shaft and it also produces vibration in it. So in order to prevent the effect of centrifugal force, another mass is attached to the opposite side of the centrifugal force. So here we are having some centrifugal force, right? So to counterattack, we will be adding another mass. So automatically there will be another centrifugal force which will be acting in the opposite direction. So what happens? Addition of this mass will try to balance the system. So this is the main aim of us. So we need to reduce the unbalance, or we need to balance the balance. I mean, we need to add some mass in order to balance it. So here we will be having two different planes. For example, here we are having a mass attached to a shaft, and here also we are having mass attached to the shaft. These two masses are revolving in different plane. So to counterattack this, I'm going to add another mass in different plane. So this will be coming under fourth case. Normally we will be having problem dealing with only fourth case, and each mass will be having the respective radius as r1, r2, r3. So in order to do this, what we're going to do is, this is done in such a way that centrifugal force of both the masses are made to be equal and opposite. That's what I said. In previous case, I'm going to add another mass so that automatically this centrifugal force will be balanced and will be equal and opposite. So the process of providing the second mass in order to counteract the effect of centrifugal force of first mass. So we call it as balancing of rotating masses. So here we are having four different cases, and case 3 and case 4 are very important. So first case is balancing of a single rotating mass by a single mass rotating in the same plane. In the same plane, I am having one mass. To counterattack it, I am adding another mass in the same plane. So M1 will be denoting first mass, and M2 will be denoting the secondary mass, and R1 and R2 are the radius of the masses M1 and M2. So centrifugal force of first mass will be FC1 is the centrifugal force of first mass, M R omega square. General formula is M R omega square. So M1 R1 omega square. So shaft will be having the same angular velocity. So we won't have different omega 1, omega 2, and all. It's common because we are having an RPM, so we can easily calculate the angular velocity. Second mass, centrifugal force for mass M2 is FC2 is equal to M2 R2 omega square. So now we'll be seeing the second case. In second case, balancing of a single rotating mass by two masses rotating in different plane. So here we are having three different planes. One will be L, and another will be A, and another one will be M. So there are three different masses, mass M1, M2, and M. So L1. So L1 is the distance between plane L and A. And L2 is the distance between plane M and A. And total distance, that is L is the distance between the plane L and M. So this is the position of planes, and here we will be having the angular position of masses. So this is the mass M, and we are having two different masses and respective radius. So this is the second case. So in this case, actually we saw a clear understanding between the static balancing and dynamic balancing. Static balancing, what happens? The net dynamic force acting on the shaft is equal to zero. So summation of the forces will be zero. Whereas in dynamic balancing, the summation of forces will be zero. In addition to it, we will also have a net couple, or a torque or moment due to the centrifugal force acting on the shaft is also zero. So summation of M is zero. So here we will be getting two equation, and dynamic balancing will be getting three equation. So, as we said already, the net force acting on the system is zero. So this the FC is the M omega square R, and FC1 means M1 omega square R1, FC2 means M2 omega 2 omega square R2. So now we're going to equate these two. That is, FC is equal to FC1 plus FC2. So just substitute whatever equation we got here. So among this, omega is the common one. So we can easily cancel the omega because its shaft will be rotating at the same angular velocity. So finally, we'll be getting an equation as MR, M1, R1, M2, R2. So this is equation one. And second equation, we already said, right, the net couple acting on the system equal to zero. So summation of the moment equal to zero. So first case, take moment about P. Now we're going to take moment about P. So what happens? So this is FC1, right? So FC1 into L equal to, this is FC. FC into L. So FC1 we can write M1 omega square R1. And L write as it is FC M omega square R. So among this, if we cancel omega square, means we'll be getting an equation like this. And if you take L on the other side, so keep M1 R1 alone left hand side and take everything to right hand side, you will be getting equation 2. In next case, we're going to take moment about Q. Taking moment about Q. So what happens? FC2 into distance. Distance is L. And here we'll be having FC into distance L1. So FC2 is M2 omega square R2 into L is equal to FC is M omega square R into L1. So cancel omega square on both the sides. And finally, we'll be having an equation like this. Take that L to the other side and keep M2 R2 on the right, left hand side. So just keep M2 R2 alone on left hand side and take everything right hand side. You will be getting third equation. So this is the case 2. In third case, what we're going to see is we will be seeing balancing of several masses, that is balancing of several masses rotating in same plane. So here we are having different masses, right? So there are, we are having different masses like M1, M1, M2, M3, M4. In order to balance these four masses, I'm going to add another masses on the same plane at some angle. So this is balancing of several masses rotating on the same plane. So this is the case 3. So here we can solve either by analytical as well as graphical method. Analytical method means summation of horizontal force. So we saw already. So M1 R1 cos theta 1. So if we resolve the masses into two different components, horizontal and vertical component, we will be getting cos theta on horizontal component and sine theta on the vertical component. So summation of horizontal and summation of vertical, we will be having the formula. So as we know, F is equal to MR. So in order to find the angular position of the mass, this is the formula. Tan theta is equal to summation of V vertical force divided by summation of horizontal force. So theta, if you want, means tan inverse of summation of vertical by summation of horizontal. So this is the analytical method. We can solve either be analytical as well as graphical. Actually, analytical method, we have solved many problems, right? So in our examination, they will be asking only graphical method and concentrate only on graphical method. And fourth case is balancing of several masses rotating in different plane. So here what happens is, so we are having different masses like M1, M2, M3, M4 like this. And we are having different masses and all the masses are rotating in different plane. And we're going to counterbalance it, right? So here we will be having the position of planes like this. So what happens is, this is the position of planes and we can write like this, like 1, 2, 3, 4 will be denoting the masses, and L and M are the, we're going to add two different masses to counterbalance these four masses, and distance they have given from reference plane. So it's our own wish, we can keep either L1 or M1 as the reference plane, and reference plane towards left will be negative and towards right will be positive, and these are the distance respective from reference plane. So here we saw two conditions, right? These two conditions must be satisfied for balancing of several masses rotating in different plane. The thing is, we will be having the moment here. We will be considering moment also. So finally, we will be formulate a tableau column like this. So here what we'll be doing is, first column will be plane. So whatever we saw here, so one L, 2, 3, M, 4, right as it is, and L is the reference plane, and M is also a plane where we will be adding a mass. In second column, we will be writing the masses like M1. If it's L, means ML. If it's M, means MM. Right as it is, and respective radius. Third column will be respective radius, and fourth column is the centrifugal force. And here we can calculate the force polygon. This tableau column is very, very important. It's just multiply the mass and radius. So once you multiply M and R, so in this centrifugal force, actually the shaft will be having the same angular velocity, right? So we can divide by omega square. So centrifugal force divided by omega square, we will be finally getting M into R. So mass we are having, radius we are having, just multiply these two columns, you'll be getting the centrifugal force. And fifth column, we will be having distance from the plane L. So L is the reference plane, right? So how much distance the remaining planes are from the reference plane? So right, we have to write like this. So plane 1 is at a distance of L1, right? Since it is in left-hand side, we are putting minus. So minus is putting minus, reason is, so since it is left of the reference plane, whatever distance we are having right of the reference plane, we can write as a positive value. So just imagine distance from the reference plane here will be zero, because the plane L, we won't have any distance, right? So we can write as zero. And plane two, so plane two will be at a distance of L2. So L2, L3, Lm, L4, you write as it is. And for last tabular column, so this tabular column is very important. Here we will be getting couple polygon. So couple is nothing but as what we did for centrifugal, just divide it by omega square, since it's a same value. So we will be having like, if you multiply these two tabular column, that is, if you multiply the centrifugal force and distance from the reference plane, we can get the couple. So centrifugal force is mr and couple is l, so mr l. So just multiply these two tabular column, you'll be getting the sixth tabular column. So we can easily get the values, and these two tabular columns are very important. Centrifugal force here, force polygon values we can plot, and here couple polygon values we can plot. These two, that is centrifugal force and couple, are very, very important. These two tabular column are very important. On whatever values are we are getting, means we'll be using it for graphical representation. And whichever tabular column we have minimum unknown, we will be using the tabular column. So regarding while solving the problem, I will be explaining in detail. In case if you have any doubt, means you just type in the comment section. Please do subscribe to my channel Mechanical Motivator and press the bell icon, then only you will be getting all the videos which I upload. Thanks for watching this video. Have a great day.